So I was listening to Megadeth's Cryptic Writings the other day, and it's not a Megadeth album I generally throw on just to listen to. I usually, you know, I like the thrash stuff. I like Rust in Peace. I like So Far, So Good, So What. I like Peace Sells. I'm liking the new album. But, you know, I've been getting into 90s Megadeth recently. You know, there's some interesting stuff there, and I threw on Cryptic Writings. Obviously, I think Trust and Almost Honest are really good tunes to start off the album. But then this song came on, and it just completely piqued my interest. What a weird thing for Megadeth. Just listen to the chord progression here real quick.
I heard somebody fix the day that was no last goodbyes the same. It's well to live. Ran out, I heard somebody turn to dust.
So if you didn't catch that there, that is a chromatic chord progression, right? So it's going from
I heard somebody fix the day, there was no last goodbyes, let's see.
So it's going from E major, G major, F sharp major, F major, back to E major, okay? Completely kind of unheard of in typical pop music form, right? I mean, and there have been many chromatic chord progressions. I'm not saying that this is the first chromatic chord progression, but it's very unique. It's not one you definitely hear. It's not something you'd hear on a Megadeth album where it opens up with an acoustic intro like that, but because it's Dave Mustaine, because the guy just has a twisted sense of melody, just has a twisted sense of building a song, I would expect nothing less. So it opens up E, G, F sharp, F. And here's the funny part, right? It doesn't go to something more melodic in the chorus or something like that, right? You expect maybe in the chorus it'll go to like a more typical chord progression. No, it sticks with that.
Looking back at what he left, list of plans and photographs.
You can't help but be intrigued by this song leading off like that. I mean, any song that leads off with like something melodic like that, because like I said, the listener is expecting something like this based on what they've heard in pop and rock music. They're expecting something. Or maybe back to the G chord. Or something C, right? That is the expected chord. But for Dave Mustaine, he's like, no, screw it. This is how I write songs. I mean, goes down that F chord, that immediately piqued my mind. And it teaches you something that sometimes throwing some unorthodox stuff together for your songs can really pique the listener's interest. I think this does a great job of that.
Thoughts that never will be sung, these are the things you won't get done.
So even does it in the chorus, right? Chord progression doesn't change.
I see the man use the needle use the man,
right? It sticks with that for the whole chorus into the next verse, right? That's just crazy to me. And then we do get a variation of that in the bridge, but right, what does he do? Does he change from the chromatic? No, now he's just changing chords. He moves, or he changes the steps. He moves up a whole step here. So now it's
cryptic writings on the wall.
So it's the same sort of Malak idea. It still has the listener engaged because it's familiar enough to what they heard in the intro, right? With that,
I heard somebody fix,
right? It's still chromatic. Moves it up a step, gives the bridge a different feel. Like, that's a classic songwriting thing, but he's putting a unique spin on it, right? Instead of taking a 1-4-5-6 and moving it up a step, right? He's taking this weird, I don't even know how you lock this into a key, really. Assuming kind of G major, okay, although it's not 100% G major, it'd be like a 6-1, like a major 7, and then, you know, a flat 6 or something like that. I don't know. I don't exactly know how to lock that into a key, but that'd be my best guess there. So that's what happens in the bridge. This is what it sounds like. A chord, G sharp, G, and back to the original riff. And here's the best part, okay? He even mixes it up more with the outro, okay? We get this super thrashy outro part here. So right there, he's going E, to G to A, and then doing this little hammer on from the second and third fret on the A string. But then so he's going from that, again, it's the same progression as the intro, okay? We're just adding some leads in. The E, and then he's doing a hammer-on, G doing a hammer-on, F sharp doing a hammer-on, F doing a hammer-on, okay? Totally awesome, totally crazy out-of-the-box songwriting there from Megadeth. It shows how versatile this band is, okay? You know, everyone likes to mention the thrash stuff. The thrash stuff is amazing, but if you go through their 90s catalog, I'm begging you, go through Euthanasia, Cryptic Writings, even Risk, people, I know. I'm gonna do a video on Risk and how there's actually some great moments on Risk, but this is totally a hidden gem on an album like Cryptic Writings, third track. I pulled up that song with that acoustic chord progression, and it's so well constructed, yet so out of the box, and really can tell us a lot about songwriting in terms of song construction. Anyways, I hope you liked that video. Please like and subscribe to the channel. We got tons of great stuff coming. Let me know what would you like me to look at and analyze. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time.